We talked about it in depth, I know that, but maybe not.
Yeah, we've talked about this game a lot, and the reason why we're bringing it up again is because we are we have a copy available on Viral Games.
Yeah, just put it up today, right?
Well, yeah, Officer Zero actually said we could have it long, like weeks ago, and yesterday I think I finally put it on.
Well, it's all good when we got around to it, which is today. Green Lantern is now a viral game.
So there are 40 achievements for 1,000 points. It's 3 out of 10 difficulty, according to X360A, which is probably reasonable, yeah.
What, a 4 out of 10?
3 out of 10.
Okay, yeah, 3 out of 10. Yeah, I agree.
So.
Maybe, could be less, dude. TA on that, on Green Lantern, is 1,171. If you use 2 controllers all the way through the game, 1 out of 10.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, I mean, I don't like keeping track of 2 controllers, though.
Well, yeah, I guess. But you can drop in and drop out, but...
Right.
You're not... Come on, now you're multi-talented. You can run with 2 controllers.
It's not something that I like to do. But
yeah, but if you have to, for the 1K, to make it easy, super easy.
Yeah. I rolled through with 2 controllers. It's just not something that I would say, you know. Not something.
But for all the people with kids out there that want to get their kids involved in GamerScore, Green Lantern is awesome.
Yep, and... Do both controllers get achievements?
No, just the first. Player one is the only one that gets the achievements.
There you go,
the
Steve.
Game is easier to play. You know, first you want to play in the hardest mode, but even the hardest mode is not even that hard. But it's, of course, a lot easier if you get a second player with you. I used my son. My son doesn't care about achievements, so he just played with me, and it helped a lot. And, I got all the achievements.
That's nice.
Yeah. And cool. It's local multiplayer only.
Right.
I think, right? I don't think there's any, like, online multiplayer.
No.
I think it's just
not.
Local.
So.
And you can also use some parts, if you do have difficulty, you can just do a second controller just to keep your guy alive, because the way that game works is you both have to – if you die and your second player two still alive – You'll respawn eventually, you know, in a small countdown. You'll respawn. Right. So I remember I did fight a couple bosses I had difficulty with. So I just got a second controller, kept the second player back. When I died, they went after the player two, but it gave me enough time for me to respawn again. So if you don't have a second person, you can still use that second player controller just to keep yourself alive longer on some of the harder spots. A little trick there.
Yep, and then just drop him out and keep going.
Yeah.
Cool. So we got a lot of story-based achievements in this thing.
Right.
Quite a few combo-based achievements. Yeah. 20
and it
combo.
It has nothing to do with the movie.
Yeah.
So, yeah, no, it doesn't
at all. The story's a little different, yeah.
But I didn't see the movie, and I heard it wasn't all that great.
Well, since we're talking about Green Lantern, did you hear the announcement DC made about Green Lantern, their alternate universe Green Lantern?
That he's...
Yeah, first gay DC character.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, so it's an alternate Green Lantern. There's like alternate universes.
Okay.
And there's an alternate Green Lantern, and he's gay. And it's like DC's first gay comic hero, which Marvel's already always had one. I think North Star was a... so the Green Lantern alternate universe is the first gay... comic hero.
Okay, they're making a movie with them?
No, they're not doing a movie. Right. This is the comic books.
Yeah. Okay.
But no, they're going to stick with the same, I'm sure they're going to stick with this universe, whatever, dimension. So, yeah. But anyways, I'm just throwing that out there because that's a little something interesting.
Hey, no.
We're talking about Green Lantern, so a little history in the making there. So.
Right. There you go.
Yeah.
So,
anyways, let's continue with the game.
So what do we need to get for the, like, as far as completion goes, it's 8 to 10 hours, but, like, where would you start if you were starting over from this game?
Well, you want to start on the hardest difficulty, which is called Emerald Knight.
Okay.
It's going to be easy anyways. Like I said, I already explained the 2 controller technique if you need help. So since there's a lot of there's not very many collectibles. There's only like 9 collectibles, which are these little meteorites, and there's green and blue ones, I believe. But you can just find a little guide on where they are, and so it's just 9 collectibles.
Well, there's 5 blue meteorites and 9 green meteorites.
Or excuse me, 9 green, 5 blue. Okay, so 14 total, yep. Collectibles. I believe too, though, the problem is it's one of those where you collect it and you have to get to the next checkpoint for it, yeah, to save it.
Yeah.
You know, like, you know, you get that problem with some of these games where you'll collect something and then you'll die right afterwards and before the checkpoint, and then it no longer registers that you collected it, and then you sometimes you think you collected it and you continue on, and then you're like, whoa, what happened? You know. So anyway, it's one of those. And they're very easy to find. The other achievements you're going to work on while playing through, besides the story mode, is leveling up your character. And yep, that's where the grinding is going to come in. But before we talk about that grinding, there is a lot of combat-related achievements. For example, yep, you know,
20 defeating enemies with the Mace Storm.
Yeah, defeating X amount of enemies with the X type of skill.
10 enemies with the Gatling gun, 10 enemies with hover mines, 10 with the blade whip, 10 with the rocket punch. But it's only 10, so it's really easy. All 15 pointers.
Yeah, and the weapons were actually pretty cool in that game, I thought. It was actually pretty, I mean, it was a pretty fun game to play. I mean, it wasn't that bad. So as you're going through, there are, like I said, I think there's the 2 missable ones can go. That you can still, even though they're missable, they say they're missable, There Is Hope and Mogo Is Proud achievement, which you can still do chapter select after you beat the game and go back and get them.
Yeah, those are the collectible achievements.
Yeah, you can go back and chapter select. So if you do miss it, don't worry. You don't have to start the entire game over. So when they're saying those are the 2 missable achievements, you can still go back. But basically, you're going to do about a 1.5 playthrough of the game, they say. The grinding is going to come in when you're trying to level up all your skills. I did my own. I didn't do the one that that 368 recommended. They recommended doing the last final boss fight one. You know.
Yeah.
But I found that to be too annoying. I just did, and I don't remember the chapter. I think it was the 3rd chapter when you're flying and shooting rocks. You know, if you're flying through space,
yeah,
and I did that one over. I figured out I timed it. It took like 3 minutes and something, I think, to beat the mission. I got X amount of XP, and I just kept doing that one over and over until I had enough XP to buy my upgrades, full upgrades and stuff. So yeah, that got boring.
The last boss.
You did,
not the last boss, but it's like the section before before you fight the last boss. A lot of enemies spawn kill them all, and then once you're fighting the last boss, you just quit.
That's what I did too.
Do it again.
That's what I did too.
I chose not to do that one.
Did that over and over and over and over and over again to get my last upgrade that was cost like 150,000 or some outrageous amount of money.
It took a while, but once you get that boss battle down, like it's pretty easy.
Yeah. No, that's cake, especially with the jet, and there's all those super green power-ups, so you just use the jet fighter on everybody and kill them all quick.
Right.
It's a piece of cake. That's the last achievement that you'll get in this game, is purchase all ring power upgrades. Unless you're crazy and replaying levels before you beat the game. Or not using a specific weapon for 10 kills. It's so easy. I'm over here dealing with like 250 kills, 350 kills on Men in Black. When I look at 10 kills with a certain weapon, it's like piece of cake.
Right. Pretty easy to get
10 missions total. Yeah. Yeah.
10 missions, that's right.
10 missions total, yep.
And then got the collectibles, Emerald Knight difficulty, and then just clean up, right?
Yep. Make sure you at least finish one mission in co-op.
Right. Which chances are you'll get anyways, because it makes things a lot easier.
Yep. Especially right off the bat on hard difficulty. Better safe than sorry, and just plug in a second control. But you're sharing a screen, so that's the only problem, is you don't have as free range movement as you would like.
Right.
Yeah, but the good part is like, isn't to use your special powers like the right trigger or something like that? So if you just like, you play with your controller, and then when you come to a boss, spam all the special moves out of your second controller just because you can, and then go back to fighting with your controller. I think that's what I was doing on the bosses. I was just using all second player special moves. And then, yeah, easy.
Easy game. Fun game.
Yep.
So, there was, well, what about the 99 hit combo? That one, you know, a little tricky, but you could, I used the ring surge and did the, well, of course, used the ring surge and then used the Gatling gun. Seemed like
yeah, the Gatling gun was probably
some people recommend the Mace Storm, but I did it with the Gatling gun.
I did it with the Gatling gun too, I'm pretty sure.
I don't remember me getting a 99 hit combo in that game.
Yeah. Not too hard. So.
No, not bad at all.
Sign up for it if you haven't played it.
Yep.
Is there anything else that we want to mention for the game?
Nope. That's it. It's Viral. Go get it.
Cool. Yeah, go get it. It's free. And in case you don't know about Viral Games, it's just a free thing that we have going on in our forums. You sign up, send us your address, and then once you comes time for the game to get passed on to you, we just send it on out, and you play it, and you send it back to us, or send it on to the next person.
It's all based on the honor system.
Right. Right. Or we'll just have to hunt you down.
If you don't have any honor, don't sign up.
Right. You have to have at least this much honor to play our games.
You got to be at least a level 10 in honor.
Yeah. How can one measure that?
Just how you measured it, Kyle. You need this much.
Yeah, that's true. Okay. Fair enough.